In this episode, I'm going to explain what is ocean, lake, sea, lagoon, island, and the difference between them all. Let's start with the ocean. The ocean is a huge body of salt water. That means ocean contains salt. Ocean covers about 71% of the Earth's surface. The planet has one global ocean, though oceanographers and the nations of the world have divided it into distinct geographic regions, the Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, and Arctic Ocean. In recent years, some oceanographers have determined that the sea around Antarctica deserves their own designation, the Southern Ocean. An estimated 97% of the world water is found in the ocean. Because of this, the ocean has considerable impact on weather, temperature, and food supply of human and other organisms. Despite its size and impact on the lives, ocean remains a mystery. More than 80% of the sea has never been mapped, explored, or even seen by human. A far greater percentage of the surface of the moon and the planet Mars have been mapped and studied than our own ocean floor has. Although there's much more to learn, oceanographers have already made some amazing discoveries. For example, we knew that the ocean contained towery mountain ranges and deep canyons known as trenches, just like those on land. The Pacific Ocean is the biggest, followed by Atlantic Ocean, followed by Indian Ocean, the fourth biggest Southern Ocean, and the last is the Arctic Ocean. Animals that live in the ocean: turtle, whale, shark, seabird, etc. We have many animals that live in the ocean. Plants that live in the ocean: red algae, seagrass, sorghum. The study of ocean is called oceanography. Sea. Sea is a part of ocean, enclosed, surrounded by land. In terms of geography, seas are smaller than ocean and are usually located where this land and ocean met. Typically, seas are partially enclosed by land. Ocean contains salt. Sea also contains salt. Because sea is a branch of the ocean that is located where the land and ocean met. All the animals and plants that live in the ocean also live in the sea. Many of you have heard of beach. Beach is the end point of a sea, also called seashore. Example of the sea and ocean we have in the world. 1. Mediterranean Sea is connected to the Atlantic Ocean. The Caribbean Sea is connected to the Atlantic Ocean. The Southern China Sea is connected to the Pacific Ocean. The Bering Sea is part of the Pacific Ocean. The Gulf of Mexico is connected to the Atlantic Ocean. The Sea of Ochotsk is part of Pacific Ocean. The East China Sea is part of Pacific Ocean. Odyssey Bay is part of Arctic Ocean. The Sea of Japan is part of Pacific Ocean. Andaman Sea is part of Indian Ocean. Remember, sea is a landlocked part of an ocean. Sea also is very big. River. A river is a natural flowing water course, usually fresh water. Or river is a water that flows naturally through a channel or a water path. River is very big in size and very deep and very long. Some rivers are big that ship and canoe can travel on it. River is a very big water. Some rivers are very giant and huge, but they flow through a channel or path. Rivers are usually flowing toward an ocean, sea, lake, or other river. In some cases, a river flows into the ground and becomes dry at the end of its course without reaching other body of water. Potamology is the scientific study of river. why limnology is the study of inland water in general. A river is a large body of fresh water flowing. All rivers have a starting point where water begins to flow. The source is called a headwater. The headwater can come from rainfall or snow melt in mountains, but it can also bubble up from the ground or from the edge of a lake or large pond. The water that flows in a river is fresh, meaning that it contains less than 1% salt. However, rivers still carry and distribute important salt and nutrients to support plant and animal life. For this reason, some of the most biodiverse habitats on our planet can be found around rivers. Collectively, scientific estimates that all the rivers in the world carry about 3.6 million metric tons of salt from land to the ocean each year. A river can also form what is called an estuary, where salty seawater mixes with fresh water near the river mouth to form. Example of river: River Niger in Nigeria, River Mississippi, Amazon River. River Nile is the longest river in the world. Stream: a small, narrow river. A flowing body of water that is smaller than a river is called stream, or Greek, or brook. Stream is also water flowing in water channel or path. Stream is small water flowing in a water channel or path. Another word for stream, also known as synonyms, is Greek or brook, as I said earlier. These are the names you can call stream. Lake: a lake is a body of water that is surrounded by land. There are millions of lakes in the world. They are found on every continent and in every kind of environment, in mountains and desert, on plain and near seashore. Lakes vary, vary greatly in size. Some measure only a few square meters and are small enough to fit backyard. Such small lakes are often referred to ponds. A lake is an area filled with water, localized in a basin, surrounded by land, apart from many rivers or other outlets that serve to feed drain lakes. Lakes lie on land and are not part of the ocean. Most of the lakes are man-made water bodies. Many lakes are artificial and are used for constructed for industry or agricultural use, for hydroelectric power generation or domestic water supply, or for aesthetic recreational purpose or other activities. Lagoon: a lagoon is a body of water separated from larger bodies of water by a big natural barrier. Lagoons are separated from larger bodies of water by sandbar, barrier reef, coral reef, or other natural barrier. Lagoon is just like lake, but lagoon is part of big water separated or captured by land. That means lagoon is a water surrounded by land, but lagoon is part of big water, while lake is not part of water. Lagoon may have outlet for water to flow. Lake did not have. The word lagoon derived from the Italian word laguna, which means pond or lake. Sometimes lagoon may be from an ocean. Island: an island or azu is any piece of subcontinental land that is surrounded by water. Sometimes it may be an ocean or sea. Because we have many lands surrounded by sea or ocean, very small islands, such as emergent land features on atoll, can be called islets, skerries, keys, or keys. An island in river or lake may be called an eyot or height. Any land that is surrounded by big water is island. Take note, lake is water surrounded by land and it has no outlet. Lake is not flowing water. Lagoon is a part of big water, especially an ocean, that is captured or surrounded by land. That means if you look at the environment of lagoon, you will find big water and not lagoon. Lagoon may have outlet to the big water. Finally, why island is a piece of land surrounded by water? We have big island just like Comoros Island in the Indian Ocean. Well, a well is an excavation or structure created in the ground by digging, driving, or drilling to access liquid resources, usually water. The well drawn or pull up by pump or fascia or using containers such as bucket. A well is a deep hole that has water inside. It is made by human being. Water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen, commonly known as H2O, and it exists in liquid, gaseous, and solid state. Water is one of the most plentiful and essential components. Water is an organic, transparent, tasteless, odorless, and nearly colorless chemical substances. Finally, river, stream, lagoon, lake, sea, well, and ocean are formed by water. You are surprised, right? Thanks for watching. Subscribe, give the video a thumbs up, and leave your comment about this video. And be expecting our next video. Take care. We love you.